In this video, I'm going to explain basic structure of foot. I'm going to explain bony structures and joint in ankle. I'd like to start from superior part. This is tibia. This is fibula. Tibia is on medial part. Fibula is on lateral part. Tibia is bigger and fibula is smaller, more thinner, okay? And below tibia, this bone, this irregular shaped bone is talus. Talus is below tibia. Joint between tibia and talus, and slightly there's a joint here with fibula. This joint is tibiotalar joint. Tibiotalar joint, okay? Tibiotalar joint, tibia, fibula, and talus. Below talus, this is calcaneus. This is heel bone. Tibia, talus, and calcaneus. There's joint between talus and calcaneus. This joint is subtalar joint. Sub means below, correct? That's why this joint is subtalar joint. I can separate subtalar joint. Joint structure of subtalar joint is very, very complicated. You see? So, research is still going on to reveal the mechanics of subtalar joint. This is very complicated. However, this joint is very important for foot mechanics. Also, tibiotalar joint is important. Tibiotalar joint and subtalar joint. Subtalar joint is very, very complicated structure, as you see. Tibia, fibula, talus, and calcaneus. Let's go to middle part. Medial part. This bone is navicular. Navicular is in front of talus. Okay? In front of talus, there is navicular. In front of navicular, there are three bones. This is cuneiform. This is medial cuneiform. This is intermediate cuneiform. This is lateral cuneiform. Remember, this is medial part of foot. Medial cuneiform, intermediate cuneiform, lateral cuneiform. Let's go to lateral part of the foot. Do you remember this bone? This is calcaneus. In front of calcaneus, there is cuboid. Cuboid, yes, because its shape is like cube. Cube kind of shape. Cuboid. This is on lateral part. Please remember these relationships. Navicular and cuneiform are on medial part. Cuboid is on lateral part. Okay? Then, in front of cuneiform and cuboid, there are metatarsal bones, especially first, second, and third metatarsals are in front of cuneiform. 1, 2, 3, they are in front of cuneiform. 1, 2, 3. Easy, right? And fourth and fifth metatarsal are in front of cuboid. 4 and 5 are in front of cuboid. Now, rest of bones are phalanges. Yeah, phalanges, like fingers. Simple enough, right? Metatarsal bones and phalanges. Review of middle part. This is navicular in front of talus. In front of navicular, there are cuneiforms, medial, intermediate, and lateral. In front of calcaneus, there is cuboid. This is lateral part. Now, in front of cuneiforms, there are three metatarsals. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. In front of cuboid, there's fourth and fifth metatarsals. Then rest of the bones are phalanges, like fingers. Okay? Now, why did I mention cuboid is on lateral part and navicular are medial part. Okay, there are arches on foot. You know, it is archy kind of the structure. There are three arches in foot. Lateral longitudinal arch, medial longitudinal arch, and transverse arch. I'm going to talk about lateral arch and medial arch. The bone compositions of lateral arch are calcaneus, cuboid, fourth and fifth metatarsals, and phalanges. So basically, this part, yes, this model is so amazing. I can separate lateral arch structures and medial arch structure. What is composition of middle arch, talus, navicular, cuneiforms, first, second, third metatarsals, and rest of phalanges? So it's like this part, talus, navicular, cuneiform, 1, 2, 3 metatarsals, and rest of phalanges, like this. See that? This is very good model. Understanding of lateral and medial arch are very important to understand ankle movement, foot mechanics, and walking mechanics. I explained the real basic of foot bones and joint. However, understanding basic anatomy is fundamental. Fundamental is always important, don't you think? So, in today's video, I explained basic anatomy of foot. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.